In the first part, we saw where ComfyUI stands in the process of image generation. I gave a simple explanation on nodes and the default workflow given by ComfyUI. Now, we will be making workflows and understand why each node in our workflow is necessary. First, I will give you an overview of how this node interacts with stable diffusion models. The large stable diffusion file we know is responsible for generating the image. It goes to his workshop, K-Sampler, to do so. Now, if I need an image of a dog, I will keep a condition for stable diffusion while generating the image. The condition will be kept by me in the form of text, also known as text-to-image generation. Now, if I write the text, a dog, and give it at the workshop, will stable diffusion be able to generate the image? No, it won't. In the case of image-to-image generation, where I have an image and I want a different variant of that image, I will give the image to stable diffusion. Will he be able to generate a variation? It won't be able to generate. Stable diffusion, known for its ability to generate images, will not be able to fulfill my request because stable diffusion will not be able to understand what I am asking for. To make it easier for everyone, let's say a stable diffusion model speaks a completely different language, something like this. This is gibberish for us humans, but stable diffusion understands only this type of language. In such cases, we will get a translator and ask him to be the middle person and explain the condition kept by us at the workshop. This is where the encoder comes in. If you right-click and look into conditions, you will find a clip text encoder. This, the middleman will encode the condition and send it to the stable diffusion's workshop to complete the request. By cloning this node, the encoder will convert our positive and the negative prompt both and will send it to the workshop, K-Sampler. Once the work is done, stable diffusion responds from his workshop by giving us latent image, which is again gibberish to us. And why not? I told you already. He didn't understand English or any normal image. Now again, we need a middleman as a decoder who can convert the latent image from the workshop to pixel image so that we humans can understand. For the decoder, right-click and check into latent. You will find VAE decode. Why this, you ask? Because the output is in latent image, not some text. As said before, stable diffusion does not understand text and image files. The newly generated latent image needs to be converted from latent space to pixel space for humans. Every model has its own style of encoding and decoding. That's why the encode and decode nodes should be connected with the models to keep things working. Clip to clip and similarly for other VAE decode. Now if I write a prompt, a dog, and generate an image, we should encounter few errors. The error says I had missed a node connection. I am using an online ComfyUI, and I forgot to delete this note before starting the explanation. I will connect this node. It is used to save the decoded image into our computer. Now, this is the error I was expecting. It says K-Sampler requires latent image. So, what is a latent image? As I explained about text, which is encoded into random letters for stable diffusion. Latent image is a random image in the latent space, for stable diffusion. Consider it as a canvas for the image, having width and height of 512, as you can see here. The model, connecting to K-Sampler, deals with latent images. The error here about latent image was like, the canvas was missing, on which the stable diffusion model was supposed to work. The stable diffusion model works in the K-Sampler on the latent image. The empty latent image is given by us, specifying the size of the image we expect in result. Stable diffusion models in K-Sampler are guided by our positive and negative prompt to modify the latent image by adding meaningful details. The output by K-Sampler is a latent image that has to be further decoded into pixel image for humans. And that's what happens in the workflow.